a school at Riverside, it feels really special. There's such a close-knit community, and it feels really homey, partly because we go to school in the house. The classes are really interactive. You can tell that the teachers love teaching.
We start our days off with assembly, which is a nice way for everyone to just kind of start their morning and say hi to everyone and get to see everyone before we go to actual classes. Assemblies are nice because we get to see a lot of different people that don't go to school too, when people come in and tell us about our community and their jobs or something, or even just when we get to play games with each other and see what everyone can do on their spare time.
Our job to make sure they throw it so good that they can't miss it. Okay. Good morning, Sky.
What are your classes like at Riverside?
They're very small, which makes it wonderful because you can get lots of one-on-one time with the teachers. Most of the kids participating because A, they know they're among friends, and B, they don't have to worry about 30 other people judging what they're doing and what they're saying. Many hands-on activities, as well as teacher-created activities that you just can't find anywhere else, whether it be Global Fair, which is when the entire school researches and does a presentation on countries all around the world, or candy sales and science clubs.
Has anyone tested to see what happens when you hit the wave harder, when you hit the water harder?
Yeah, I did.
Does the wave move faster? Does the amplitude go higher? What happens?
Let's find out. It seems like it bounces.
Riverside prepared me for St. Johnsbury Academy and Dartmouth College. First of all, I got to interact with adults one-on-one here, and that certainly helped me in high school with coaches, teachers, others. Some of them said to me, "You Riverside kids seem to work well with adults." Teachers were very energetic, very passionate about their subjects, and wanted to transmit that, and they could. They could transmit their passion for the subjects, at least to me, and I think to others.
Because the students work hard, they get their homework done, they ask good questions, they're engaged. It's a terrific place to teach. When I think about spending my day here, I think about being able to walk around the building and seeing students engaged in their lessons. I'm able to see students very comfortable with one another, regardless of their age, being able to interact with one another and interact with faculty members, and being really self-confident with their conversations, and very caring and compassionate towards one another.
Lunch at Riverside, in most days, begins with the arrival of Ray's lunch truck. There we can buy hot foods, snacks, and drinks. On one day a week, we order pizza from a local restaurant. After Nelia picks up the pizza, we bring it into the barn. And Peter thinks it's funny when he gets to say,
"Enjoy your breakfast!"
On certain days of the week, there are special activities at lunch, such as student council meetings. This is where elected students from each grade meet to discuss plans for special events and activities. Sometimes we have buddy lunches. This is where we try to make friends by pairing up younger and older students. After we eat, we have a lot of free time to play Foursquare outside in the warm months and inside during the winter, to keep up an ongoing board game, or just to relax with friends. At 1 o'clock, the teachers announce
class time,
and then we move on to choice class.